Hello internet and welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions, the place where our most prominent quality is that no hypothetical scenario is ever out of reach, particularly when it comes to the tug of war of the geopolitical landscape. In fact, we kind of enjoy the challenge. What's going on guys? As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we unhook the dossier, shuffle in our seat and politely cough as we kindly ask the powers that be not to hit that big red button and cautiously ask the question, what would happen if a nuclear weapon hit the USA? Roll the clip. As Robert Oppenheimer famously remarked after the first atomic bomb was detonated on July 16th, 1945 in the Trinity test at New Mexico, now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds. He knew it at the time that his groundbreaking work in theoretical physics would usher in a terrifying new age of nuclear proliferation, a mass arms race to build it bigger, better and more destructive, and he was right. The threat of mutually assured destruction still looms over our planet like a dark, foreboding cloud, and we're sincerely hoping that it doesn't rain. Before we figure out the weather report though, you know the drill by now. Question is, if you're a fan of this video, theoretical physics, atomic energy, or just LBQ in general, then be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell so you can stay up to date with our latest and greatest uploads. If you'd like to get in touch with the creative team here at LBQ, then be sure to take a peek at the info box down below. On with the show. Since the Cold War that was held between the United States and the former Soviet Union, that tentatively ran between 1947 and 1991, although some would say it's hard to deny the fact that tensions still run deep to this day, the global lexicon shifted and terms like nuclear arms race, mutually assured destruction and doomsday clock crept their way into our shared global language. It would come after the looming memory of the US-led atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki that eventually led to the final phase of World War II and would form the basis and rationale of the global nuclear arms race. Now there are more than 8 countries that possess or declare possession of a nuclear weapon: the United States, Russia, the United Kingdom, France, China, India, Pakistan, North Korea, and potentially Israel. Well, in our hypothetical scenario, let's say the destruction wrought if one or many of these nuclear warheads was put to use, more specifically in the United States of America. First, let's see what actually happens if a nuclear weapon is detonated. Two hemispheres of uranium that are often doped with plutonium and polonium are forced into each other, often using conventional explosives. Neutrons in this critical mass collide at high speed with atoms, which then split in the process of nuclear fission, releasing energy atop more neutrons, which cause a chain reaction of catastrophic energy. In a hydrogen bomb, this reaction is utilized to force hydrogen nuclei together in a fusion process to form a helium atom that creates a chain reaction and releases even more energy. It's a devastating force, the likes of which can change the course of a country, continent, or our entire planet. Now, although it does depend entirely on destination, it goes without saying that it doesn't really matter where it's dropped in the United States, as the end result would inevitably be the same. But say that a theoretical bomb is dropped with a purpose, to send a message to the USA, much like with Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which were targeted by the US Targeting Committee in the Second World War. An area of large, flat and dense population is preferential, particularly if they have an industrial significance. In our hypothetical scenario, cities like Houston, Chicago and New York would be appropriate targets. For the sake of brevity, let's say that city is New York, a city that contains a population of 8.5 million people, 139,000 of which work in manufacturing and industrial occupations, the second largest in the country. Houston has the largest, but similar to the Nagasaki situation, areas with close proximity to mountains and hill ranges are detrimental to nuclear fallout. And although Houston is relatively flat, it's heavily wooded for the most part, and Texas as a whole is a very mountainous state in connection to the rest of the country. It's pretty morbid, but whoever would be sending this hypothetical nuclear bomb would be looking for maximum damage. Also, we can't deny the culturally significant impact that New York City has, which would definitely play a major part for our would-be perpetrator. Also, we're not going to sugarcoat it, but New York was the place that the North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un said that his newly tested nuclear arsenal could hit. If a 150-kiloton hydrogen bomb was dropped right on the center of New York City Hall, it would create a massive fireball with a radius of approximately 1.9 square kilometers, a devastating infernal storm that would consume the immediate area. At the epicenter center of a nuclear blast, the core temperature would reach 150 million Fahrenheit or 66 million Celsius, enough to vaporize rock, metal, and combust a living human to utter nothingness. In its radius, the Supreme Court would go up in flames, along with the city's public library and Lower Manhattan Hospital. All gone, wiped off the map instantly. In a sense, those are the lucky ones, because the blast radius would completely obliterate up to 5 kilometers across the city, leveling the entire financial district, Trump Tower included. Most residential buildings in a 20-kilometer radius would be completely leveled or the foundations destroyed, causing a cascade of crumbling buildings. People that are caught within 12 square kilometers of the blast would likely suffer a 50 to 90% mortality rate due to the instant levels of radiation, with death taking between several hours and several weeks. New York would instantly become uninhabitable for decades to come, and the survivors of the fallout would be on precious time to instantly flee the area or risk apocalyptic levels of radiation. All in all, NukeMap, a website which simulates such a catastrophic event, estimates that a nuclear explosion on New York City could cause an unimaginable 800,000 deaths and twice as many injuries. But of course, that doesn't take into account the nuclear fallout of such a devastating event. Due to the landscape of New York State and its close proximity to the East Coast, the prevailing winds of the area could spread the nuclear fallout anywhere between 23 kilometers and 6.5 thousand kilometers squared, meaning that a nuclear strike could and would significantly affect the rest of the United States. Places such as Dallas, Kansas City, Chicago, even Toronto, a strike could even spread as far as San Francisco and Los Angeles on the West Coast, as well as most of Mexico and Central America. If a nuclear weapon hit the USA, our planet would never be the same again, and both the social, cultural, and physical impact would shape our species toward a much darker path. Have you ever seen or read The Road? Yeah, nukes are bad, guys. Don't drop them. Well, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way to the end. Speak your mind in the comment box down below, and to continue on with your question in binge, be sure to hit that playlist floating shortly above. As per usual, I've been your host, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.